Stop thinking good of your dad. Hello and welcome. In this video, I'll be picking up where we last left off with Jojo's Bizarre Adventure. I'll be breaking down all the grammar and vocabulary from this manga. Below me, I'll be pasting in definitions. And over on the side, as you can see, I have the manga up, so I can move along, like show you where we are as we go along. So this is last page we did from last time. And here we see Dio, he's messing about the house and he's found this funny looking mask on the wall and he just picks it up, but Joestar noticed. Oh shoot, can't just go sell it. Sorry Dio. So, to start off, we have this. すみません, Joestar 今日勝手に触ったりして? So, すみません, is like, I'm sorry. And Joestar, that's his name, that's like the last name. Jonathan Joestar, that's all of their last names. Until they start being Japanese. Because they're still like in London at this time. And then 今日 here is Lord or Sir. And then 勝手に is arbitrarily on your own accord of your own volition. So like, without asking, I just went and grabbed this. And he's saying that the 触ったりして, that is the tari form of 触る, which is to touch or to feel. And that is a godan do ending verb. So you would first change it to its past form essentially, and then add on this d. So to make it to that past form, that do that would be here is switched out with this tanitsu and a ta, and then there's that d. So 触る becomes our 触ったり. And this isn't the full grammar form, but you do see here it's like dot dot dot, he's going off. This should be like tari tari suru, which would mean like doing things like A and B. So this should be more like 触ったり, 食べたり suru とか, which should be like touching and eating. But there should be like another verb here to finish the grammar form, but he's kind of just leaving it off here. Because this here is the suru, but it's in its te form for shite. And the te form can indicate that you're just kind of like, you're trailing off, you're not finishing your sentence, which is what he's doing here. And next, we have すごく yokimina kamen na mono de. So すごく is really, and this yokimi is weird or ominous. And this na, this is a na adjective, so it means this na to attach it to kamen, which means mask, like kamen raider, but not. So this is a weird mask, yokimi na kamen, which is like a weird eerie mask. And then we have this same na here, attaching it to mono, which just means a thing or an object. It's like, this object is a weird mask, a super weird mask. Then day is like because of, it's indicating the means of an action. So like, he's kind of inferring like, I had to take it up because it's so weird. And next we have this pekori, which he's kind of like, he's bowing his head here. He's like, I'm sorry. It's kind of a common Japanese thing to show respect, or he's apologizing to bow a little bit. And he's like, yeah, yeah, kamawan yo. So this is yeah, yeah, which means like, no, by all means, it's fine. Just touch my antiques, I don't mind. And then kamawan is no problem or doesn't matter. It's kind of short for kamawanai. And then this yo is adding emphasis, like, no, 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 it's no problem. Don't worry about it. Now he's going to explain the ishi kamen. So sono, which means that, which is because it's over here in Dio's hands. And then ishi kamen. This ishi means stone. And this is the same kamen from before, which means mask. So this makes it stone mask, and wa makes that stone mask the topic of the sentence. And then Mexico is Mexico, and then no, linking that up to iseki, which means ruins, like remains, relics. And then kara is from. So that mask came from like Mexican ruins. はっくつ された もの だ そうだ. So はっくつ is an excavation or like a discovery. And then this sareta is the past form of sareru, which is kind of the honorific or passive version of suru. So it's kind of just a more fancier way of saying suru, and this is in its past form. And that saseru is an ichiran ru ending verb. So to make it past, that ru becomes our ta. So sareru becomes sareta. So like it was done, it was excavated. And that's describing mono, which is thing. the same owner from here, and it's referring to the thing that mask. That thing is something that was excavated in the Mexican ruins. And then da here is declarative, and the soda is like, that's so, or that seems to be the case, or I'm of that impression. So it's like, I believe that was excavated from some ruins in Mexico. Next, this gets a little sad. Bring out your hankies. Because we first have sore wa, as for that, and then Jojo, that's Jojo, that's Jojo's name, our protagonist. And then ga makes him the subject of the sentence. So as for Jojo, umareta bakari no koro ryoko o shite ne. So umareta is the past form of umareru, which means to be born. And that is an ichiran ryu ending verb. So that ryu changes to ta to make it past. So instead of a ryu, we have this ta here. So umareru, umareta. And then bakari is just or only, so just after being born. And then no is linking that to koro, which is time. So like the approximate time, like the time right after being born. So it's like right after Jojo was born. And then ryoko is a trip. And then o makes that the direct object. And then the shite is the te form of suru, which means to do. That's just an irregular verb. So you have to memorize that suru becomes shite. And then this ne here is adding emphasis. So like right after Jojo was born, we went on a trip. We have this nandan no bijutsusho kara kini itte katta mono da. So nandan is London's London. And then no is linking that to this bijutsusho, which is an art dealer. So an art dealer in London. And kara is from. So from an art dealer in London. Kini itte is the te form of kini iru, which is to be pleased with or to suit. So it's like, I saw it and I thought it was good. And that is a gonan ryu ending verb. So to make it to its te form, that ryu just gets swapped out with this tanitsu ne te. So kini iru becomes our kini itte. And that is linking that, because te form can kind of mean and like in English. So you're doing this and you're also doing this other verb too, which is kata, which is the past form of kao, which means to buy or to purchase. And that is a godan u ending verb. So to make it to its past form, that u, kau, becomes katta. This tanitsu and a ta. So I liked it and I bought it. And then mono is a thing or an object. So this is all like describing the thing. The object was something that I liked and I bought from an art dealer in London. And then da is just declarative. Like that's the fact. That's what happened. And next we have その帰りに馬車で事故を起こした。Oh no. So その that and 帰り is return. The に is showing like the time of the action. So like when on the way back from that, 馬車 is a horse-drawn carriage or coach. Because this right here is 馬 for a horse and then like 車 for car. So you put them together, they become basha, which is like a horse car, or like a carriage. And then de is by means of, so like by means of a horse carriage. And then jiko is an accident. And then this o makes that the direct object. And then okoshita is the past form of okosu, which is to occur. And that is a goran su ending verb, so to make it the past, that su becomes our shita. So okosu becomes okoshita. So, on our way back, by a carriage, an incident occurred. Oh no. And then we have this. Well, we knew this part, but it's still sad. Tsuma o ushinatta ka. So, tsuma is his wife, and then o makes that the direct object. And then ushinatta is the past form of ushinau, which means to lose or to part with. That is a godan u ending verb. So just like kata we had here, it's the same one. So the kau becomes kata and the ushinau becomes ushinatta, which is the past form, so lost or parted with. And then God's kind of making that the subject. So I lost my wife in this accident with the carriage. Next, watashi to Jojo no inochi o sukutte kureta no ga kimi no otosan nanda yo. So watashi is I, to is and, And then Jojo, again, is Jojo, our protagonist. So me and Jojo, and then no is linking that to inochi, which means life. So our lives, and then o makes our lives a direct object. Then we have tsukutte kureta. That is the te kureru past form of suku, which is to rescue, to help, or to save. And to first make that into its te kureru form, to make suku to its te form, that u changes to this tiny tsu and a te that you see here. So suku becomes tsukutte. And then you would just add on the kureru for tsukutte kureru, which would mean like do that favor for the speaker, like they did me the favor of saving me. But this is also in its past form. And kureru makes it to an ichiran verb, because kureru is ichiran. So for that, you would just change out that ru for ta. So our kureru becomes our kureta. So we have this from suku to tsukutte kureru to tsukutte kureta. I was saved by someone. We'll say who that is next. And then no is nominalizing that. So it kind of makes this whole thing into a noun, so we then can make it the subject of the sentence. So the thing of having our lives saved, ga, as for that, this kimi no otosan nanda yo. So kimi is you, and then no is showing possession of otosan, which means dad. So kimi no otosan is your dad, your father. And then nanda, this is like another form of nanoda. It is assuredly that, or I can say with confidence, it was because of your father that we were saved. And then this yo is having emphasis. But that's a lie! It's a lie! He just happened to be there. Dio's dad, like, found them in their horse carriage, all dying and stuff. It's like, oh, these people are rich. I'll go, like, take their stuff. But they were still alive, so I kind of just ended up helping them inadvertently, not on purpose. It's like, no, stop thinking good of Dio's dad. It's not true. All right. Next we have this. Tsurai omoide da ga. Oh, yeah. So tsurai. Tsurai is painful, bitter, or heartbreaking. And then the omoide is memories or recollections. And then da ga is like but or however. So it's like, it's a painful memory, but... And this part's weird. I don't know why you would do this. This is 妻の写真代わりにそこにかけてあるのだよ。So 妻, again, is his wife. And no is linked to 写真. It's like a picture of my wife. 妻の写真. And then 代わりに, ga is making that the subject. So as for that picture, and then 代わりに is rather or comparatively. So like instead of a picture of my wife, soko is there, that place he's referring like to the on the wall where the picture was hung up. And then ni is showing the location, so like at that place, at over there. And then kakete, the te form of kakeru, which is to hang, so like hanging up a picture or something like on the wall. It's an ichiran ru ending verb, so to make that te, that ru just becomes te, so kakeru becomes our kakete. And then that te is linking it to aru, just to exist. So it's like, I hung it and have it there. And then no here is adding an explanatory tone. Da is declarative. And then yo is emphasis. So it's like, it's the fact of the matter is, there on the wall I hung that thing instead of having a picture of my wife. Which is weird. Why not just have a picture of her? But instead you got this creepy mask. Okay. He's like inspecting it, you know, he probably wants to sell it. So he's like, kari kari, he's like scratching it. And then kuru, he's like flipping it around. Next he's like, oh, there's all this text here. First he's saying, a kamen, which is mask. And then no, he's linking that to ura, which is the backside. Like so, the underside behind the mask. So, kamen no ura ni nani yara moji ga horarete imasu ne. So ni is showing the like the location, so at the backside or on the backside. And this nani yara is interesting. That means like something or for some reason. And then moji are characters, so some kind of characters. And then ga makes them the subject. Next we got this big old verb right here. This horarete imasu, horarete imasu is the passive te iru masu form of horu, just horu, a tiny little verb becomes all of this. And anyway, horu means like to carve or to engrave. So like, you know, these characters are engraved on the back. It's essentially what he's saying, or like asking like, what are these characters? To first make it passive, which would mean it'd be done by someone or something, carved by someone, that horu is a godan ryu ending verb. So you would change that u based ending to its a based ending and then add on neru. So horu will become hora, horareru. So that's where we got that horare, and then nu becomes all this. Because next we're changing it to its teiru, and like all passive forms are ichiran verbs, so like from here on out, it's being conjugated as ichiran. So that ryu that would be here is being swapped to this te for its te form, and then you would be adding iru to make it into its teiru form, which is like the garan, so like doing that action or just being in the state of having that done, which is what's going on here. It's like in the state of having these carved into it. So that horareru becomes horareteiru, but that ryu, that ryu that would be here is also being flopped out with mas. To make the mas form, the ichiran verb, you just take the ryu and change it to mas, which is what we're seeing right here. And that is just making it polite. That's all that's doing. No extra context. And then this ne is like adding emphasis or request for confirmation. So it's like, you know, on the back of the mask, some kind of letters inscribed here. What's up with that? Next, Jojo's dad, who's so insightful. He's just like, umu, yeah. And then we have this. Azuteka toyu bunmei ga atte sono moji da sou da. So Aztec here, Azuteka. And then toyu, like to be called. And then bunmei is a culture or a civilization. So like the culture or civilization referred to as Aztecs, kind of like the Aztec culture or Aztec civilization. Ga makes that the subject, so as for Aztecs. And then atte is the te form of aru. Change that to its te form, that ru changes to this tanitsuirete. So aru becomes atte. That means to exist, so like the Aztecs existed. And then like these characters are from them. So sono, those. And then moji, again the same moji we saw here, which means characters or letters or alphabet. So those letters. And then dasoda is like it appears to be the case. Da here is declarative, and soda is that's what it looks like, that's what I think it is, I'm under the impression of that. Those characters are from the Aztec civilization. Next, we have his little bit here. So imi is meaning or significance, and wa makes that the topics. Like as for the meaning, like what they mean. Kaidoku is deciphering or decoding, and then shitoran is like, no, we haven't done that. This is really interesting, I guess. Jojo's dad here is speaking in kanzai because this is the kanzai form of teinai. So for this, suru in its te form becomes shite, and then that te is changing to to, and we're adding on nan. So shite to shitoran. And that's like the negative progressive, so like you weren't doing that. So like no one's been able to do it, no one has done the deciphering of the meaning of those characters. And then ne here is adding emphasis. So that's like no one's deciphered it, nobody knows. Next, this is the only thing Dio really cares about. Koka na mono desu ka? So koka is high price. And then na, this is a na adjective, so this na is linking that to mono, which is thing. It's kind of interesting. We've seen mono before, like here mono, but here we're actually seeing it with the kanji. We haven't seen that, like, at least in a while in this manga. So that's what the mono kanji looks like. And there can be like two different kanji for mono. If this had a different kanji, it has one that's specifically for people, because mono can mean people, but this kanji is used when it means things, which obviously he's asking if this is expensive. So koka na mono is expensive item. And then des is adding politeness, and ka is indicating a question. So, is this an expensive thing? How much is this worth? Right, he just wants to sell it. That's why he's sticking around with it. Oh, oh. So, it, yeah. So, sahodo demo nai na. So, yeah is like disagreeable or reluctant, but it's just like no right here. It's like, no, not really. this sahodo is like, yeah, not particularly or not really. And the demonai again is like neither nor. So it's like, no, it's not really. It's like neither nor. It's not really expensive or cheap. It's nothing particularly special. If you're trying to hawk it, which is what you're doing. And then this na is just emphasis. Oh man, we have done all of this. Oh, this is a killer phage. Thanks for sticking around till the end. This was a lot of words, but hopefully you've learned something and had some fun. And if you want to see what happens next with this stone mask, does he hawk it? We'll see that in the next video, so please subscribe to see that. And I will see you there. Mata ne.